Hi friends, I am Dr. B.V. Rao of Usha Clinic and founder of the websites qmedicaldoubts.com and raghvamedicaldoubts.com. Through these videos, I am providing the basic knowledge about the commonly occurring diseases, treatment and surgery details when necessary for the medical knowledge to general people and for reference to medicals. Today, I am going to discuss about the pre-eclamptic toxemia of pregnancy. These are a heterogeneous collection of diseases mostly related to pregnancy, classified based on American Committee of Maternal Welfare, describes as below. Acute toxemia of pregnancy starting after the 24th week of pregnancy, pre-eclamptic toxemia, a mild and severe. And eclampsia associated with hypertension, proteinuria or edema resulting in convulsions, coma or both. Chronic hypertensive disease with pregnancy, it is vascular in nature. Without superimposed toxemia, that is no exacerbation of hypertension or albuminuria. Hypertension known to have before pregnancy. Hypertension developed during pregnancy before 24th week and persistence in postpartum period. Chronic hypertensive vascular disease with superimposed toxemia. Unclassified toxemia. For diagnosis, date is not sufficient. Pre-eclamptic toxemia and eclampsia. These two forms are the common, important and true forms of toxemia. Pre-eclamptic toxemia is presenting rise in blood pressure, edema and albuminuria. If neglected, ends in eclampsia and convulsion. Causative factors. Occurs chiefly in primigravida. Frequent in multiple pregnancy, hydramnios and vascular mole. Due to increase in vowel distension of the uterus and increase in intra-abdominal pressure. Maternal diseases like diabetes mellitus, hypertension and renal disorders and emotional stress. Pre-eclampsia is characterized by reduced volume, reduced glomerular filtration rate and renal blood flow and a reduced aldosterone secretion rate. There is a sodium retention and a shift of sodium into the arterial walls, which may be a factor in the increased sensitivity to pressure agents in the preeclampsia. There are renal lesions responsible in preeclampsia and eclampsia. Role of placenta. Some findings are found more in preeclampsia or increased syncytial knots. True infarcts, loss of syncytium, proliferation of cytotrophoblasts, villous necrosis, acute fibrinoid degeneration of maternal decidual arteries, etc. are responsible. Pathogenesis of hypertension in preeclampsia. The increased response to angiotensin over the arterial walls produces the hypertension. Adrenocortical hormones, the hyperactivity of the adrenals may also be due to the corticotropin produced by the placenta. Adrenal cortex undergoes hyperplasia, secretes excessive cortical metabolites resulting in edema, proteinuria and hypertension. Prostaglandins. The evidence is increasing still, its role is still speculative. Dietetic deficiency. Good antenatal care has almost eliminated the incidence of preeclampsia. There has not been reduced the preeclamptic toxemia. Signs and symptoms. The onset of the disease is insidious. The signs include high blood pressure, edema and albuminuria. Either all or some of them may be present. Hypertension. the reading of 140 by 90 and above is considered to be hypertension. It is usually the first thing to appear. The steadily increasing blood pressure indicates the severity of the toxemia, edema. Sometimes it is the first symptom, the pitting edema persisting even after bed rest of nearly 12 hours or if the edema is present over the face, hands, abdominal wall or labia, it should be considered as abnormal. Varying grades of edema are found in pre-eclampsia in severe cases. The patient is waterlogged. Weight changes. The abnormal retention of water in the tissue spaces before the edema is manifest is observed. The average weight gain in whole period of pregnancy may be 5 to 9 kg. The weight gain at the rate at which the weight is put on is important. Any patient putting on weight more than 1 kg per week is due to retention of fluid in the tissues. Occult edema, some patients may get toxemia without weight gain. Proteinuria. Protein in the urine is present after the appearance of the hypertension and edema. Spasm of the glomerular capillaries results due to anoxia of glomeruli and this gives rise to endothelial damage. As a result, the proteins escape in the urine. In addition to protein, hyaline casts may be present in the urine. The symptoms of severe toxemia along with the edema, hypertension and proteinuria are restlessness, headache, vomiting, dimness of vision, epigastric pain and sometimes sudden blindness may be there. The cases, if not treated promptly, may develop convulsions and eclampsia. Sometimes convulsions may start without any warning symptoms. Clinically, the preeclampsia is classified into mild and severe types depending on the degree of symptoms. Mild type. A patient with a blood pressure of 150 mm of mercury systolic, mild edema and proteinuria with symptoms like headache, vomiting and visual disturbance is termed the mild type. When the blood pressure is more than 150 mm of Hg, the condition is termed the severe type. When this is associated with restlessness, headache, vomiting and visual disturbance, it is called the threatening eclampsia. There may be sudden convulsions in any type. Biochemical changes in toxemia. In severe cases of preeclamptic toxemia, there is a rise in serum uric acid. Studies in sodium balance reveal that in toxemia there is a delay in excretion of sodium resulting delay in excretion of sodium. As a result of sodium retention, the blood chlorides are increased. There is hemoconcentration. Serum protein levels are lower than in normal pregnancy levels and albumin fraction is most effective. There is an increase in the urinary and serum levels of chorionic gonadotropin while there is a fall in the estrogen and progesterone content of the blood. There is a definite diminution in blood supply to placenta and fall in renal blood flow and glomerular filtration rate. Changes in the fundus oculi. In examination of toxemia, routine examination of fundus oculi became necessary. Retinal changes are graded as follows. Grade 0, normal fundus. Grade 1 and 2, slight to moderate degree of reflex strip, arteriovenous narrowing and spasm called the stage of angiospasm. Grade 3, toxemic retinopathy, moderate degree of reflex strip, arteriovenous narrowing and spasm and hemorrhage and edema and exudates may be found. Stage 4. Papillary edema is present. The condition is to be differentiated from renal disease and hypertension complicating pregnancy to be differentiated by history. History of pre-existing renal disease, hypertension before pregnancy favor diagnosis of a hypertensive vascular disease than preeclampsia. Onset of time of symptoms. In preeclampsia, the symptoms start after the 24th week and never before the 20th week. Parity. Common in primae gravida. Signs and symptoms. Hypertension, edema and proteinuria are present in preeclampsia. Urinary findings. All types of casts are present. Hyaline, granular and epithelial casts is in favor of renal disease. Renal function. In renal disease, urea clearance values are lower and blood urea is raised in later stages. In severe preeclampsia, the blood uric acid is elevated and uric acid clearance lowered. Optic fundus. Albuminuric retinitis, cotton wool patches and flame-shaped hemorrhages are diagnostic of renal damage. After delivery, the signs and symptoms totally subside in toxemia, unlike renal disease. Prognosis. Immediate prognosis. In neglected cases, onset of convulsions, eclampsia, premature suppuration of placenta, accidental hemorrhage, fatal death, and result in premature labor. Remote prognosis. There is possibility of residual hypertension and toxemia in the next pregnancy, is called recurrent toxemia. Treatment. Mild cases are treated by bed rest for few days. Diet with restriction of salt, high calories of about 2500 calories, low protein and very low fat. Generous intake of fluids is encouraged. Diuretics. Diuretics like furosemide and hydrochlorothiazide are used for diuresis and control of edema. Severe cases. The aim of the treatment is to prevent convulsions, aim at delivery of a live child. General measures. Patient is advised to rest in bed to one side or the other to encourage urination. Fluid intake and output chart is maintained. Blood pressure and urine per protein charts are maintained. Diet. The patient is given only liquids, barley, fruits, fruit juices and dilute milk are advised. The amount of fluids need not be restricted. As the condition improves, fluid diet is replaced by normal diet with restrictions. Sedatives. Sedatives like phenobarbital or diazepam can be given by intravenously or by drip. Control of blood pressure. The most important is the rest. Physical and mental. If blood pressure is high, intravenous injection of eprisolin 20 mg in 20 ml of 5% glucose injected slowly. Other drugs include protaveratrone, guanidine, chlorpromazine by parenteral route. Control of edema and proteinuria. Absolute rest will control the edema. Diuretics also can be used. Hypertonic glucose solution intravenously 100 to 500 ml daily may control edema and improve diuresis. This regimen usually clears the toxemia. If not, may lead to complications and lead to terminate the pregnancy. The indications may be to prevent the onset of eclampsia, to prevent the intrauterine death of the fetus. Some patients may exhibit threatening eclampsia. There is a severe headache, restlessness, epigastric pain, vomiting and visual disturbance. In such cases, if within few hours of the administration of the sedatives and hypertensives, the symptoms are not brought under control, irrespective of the period, may enhance the dangers to the mother and the child. So termination of pregnancy is advised. The eye fields are frequently tested and if grade 3 and 4 are found, termination of pregnancy is advised. Preeclamptic toxemia is advised, is associated with a high perinatal mortality, so when not responding to treatment, induction of premature labor has to be resorted. If near 36 weeks of pregnancy in absence of threatening eclampsia, it is safe to postpone termination up to 36th week of pregnancy to save the baby. Methods of termination of pregnancy: artificial rupture of membranes and caesarean section. In case of cervix is effaced and presenting part is engaged, ERM is an ideal method. Labor starts quickly when artificial rupture of membranes is performed below the presenting part and follows the normal course. When the cervix is not effaced and the presenting part not engaged in primae gravida, artificial rupture of membranes is followed by the long latent period before the true pain starts. So in these cases, the caesarean section is indicated. In primae gravida with a disproportionate and elderly pregnant, caesarean section is indicated. The babies born in such situations are small and premature. To save such size caesarean section, the general anesthesia is avoided. Epidural local anesthesia is preferred and lower segment caesarean section is preferable. If there is no immediate danger of eclampsia, the pregnancy is to be terminated. A modified surgical induction can be employed. In case of closed, uneffaced cervix and unengaged head, as an alternative to caesarean section, the membranes are stripped by the finger all round the external os, and the patient is started on an intravenous oxytocin drip for 2.5 units in 500 ml of 5% glucose. The rate of drip is adjusted according to nature of the contractions, usually 20 to 30 drops per minute, not more than 10 units in 24 hours. When the uterus begins to contract, the membranes are ruptured below the presenting part. If there is no urgency, the oxytocin drip is repeated following 2 days. After ERM, it is not advisable to wait for more than 24 hours. If necessary, caesarean section may be sought. Management of labor. The aim of management of labor in these cases is to prevent the eclampsia and to save the fetus. It is achieved by keeping the patient under sedation during labor. Blood pressure is kept under control. Duration of labor is maintained. Pethidine 100 mg is given intramuscularly as a routine and repeated every 6 hours. Antihypertensives are given by IV to accelerate labor. Membranes are ruptured and if head is down, delivered by vacuum extraction or by forceps after pudendal block. Sedation is continued if necessary for another 48 hours. Prophylactical antibiotics and intravenous administration of 25% dextrose is used. In case of very high blood pressure, elderly primary gravida, severe preeclampsia, cephalopelvic disproportion, uterine inertia, caesarean section is the choice. It is necessary to continue medical management in postpartum period. The signs and symptoms disappear in few weeks. Future pregnancies and toxemia. In some cases, after a gap of time in next pregnancy, there appears the proteinuria, hypertension and edema. It is the recurrent toxemia. It may be skipped in some pregnancies in between and is to be treated as a preeclamptic toxemia and as an inpatient. If possible, ERM is avoided and also caesarean section. That's all about the preeclamptic toxemia, and in the next video I will discuss about some other disease. Thank you.